Welcome to KELA's Let's Talk About It. Discussions on a variety of topics of interest to Southwest Washington area listeners. Write down our listener call-in number and keep it handy. 330-5352. That's 330-KELA. You're invited to join in with your calls now at 330-KELA. Views expressed on this show are those of the host, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of the station, its management, or advertisers. Daily programs are recorded for playback, podcasts, and promotional purposes. And now, let's talk about it.
Good morning, and welcome back to the Let's Talk About It show on AM 1470 KELA. And boy, that was a long intro. I'm not used to such a long intro now that I do Let's Talk About It on Sundays, which are a much quicker show. But today, I know this is an anticipated show because this is the fun show where we get to hear from local candidates who chose to respond about what their vision is for the community and what they want to see in the community. And you get the opportunity to listen to them, not just maybe read a quote or see what they've dropped off at your doorstep, but to actually hear from them on a candidate statement. So let's the first one's going to be Dianne Dorey. Dianne Dorey is former Lewis County assessor. She's one of those everywhere people who, you know, used to be part of the Miss Lewis County Board, United Way Board, but now she's running for the Centralia Port, and she wants to be a port commissioner, and she's asking for your vote. So let's get right to it, and let's hear from Dianne Dorey.
Good morning. My name is Dianne Dorey, and I'm running for the Port of Centralia District 3 Commissioner. After retiring from the Lewis County Assessor's Office with 47 years of service to Lewis County citizens, I was asked why I would want to run for public office again. The answer was simple. I received a wonderful education while working in the office. My duties included calculating levies and taxes for the approximate 65 taxing districts annually, auditing property tax budgets for accuracy, appraising real and personal property for valuation purposes, networking with businesses that are existing and thinking about locating in Lewis County, overseeing a staff that was upwards of 25, managing a $1.9 million budget, and leadership responsibilities within my peer groups at a state level. I was elected twice as the Washington State Association of County Assessors President and once as the Washington Association of County Officials. This was a great vote of confidence in my leadership skills. In 2023, I was voted the Chamber Evergreen Award winner. This was a very prestigious honor in this community.
If you're elected as a member of the Centralia Port, what's the top issue you'd like to address?
What do I bring to the table to help the port in the future? Leadership, collaboration, knowledge, experience, and education. Bringing family wage jobs to this area not only enriches our quality of life, but also enhances the community to make it stronger and more cohesive. We need a plan for the next 20 years. The port's inventory of property is getting smaller. I have many ideas on how we can remedy this. When any of the larger businesses locate in Lewis County, it helps all taxpayers by reducing the county current expense levy and the state levy.
There's been a lot of internal turmoil surrounding the port in the news, such as conflicts of interest, interference with labor practices, and transparency concerns. If elected, how would you resolve those issues to strengthen trust with the community?
We need a leader who not only asks questions, but does it in a manner that aims to resolve issues and collaborate with the stakeholders. The stakeholders include citizens, port staff, news media, and all folks with interest in the port. The current port commissioner representing District 3 voted twice against the Winco project. We need a leader that will not wait until the last minute to vote against a project that was years in the making.
All right. So that was Dianne Dorey, who is running against Peter Lahmann for port commissioner. He's the current incumbent, and you're going to hear from him. I think you're going to hear from him. He's going to be like the last candidate to give their speech. So you're going to hear from him. So the next candidate that we're going to hear from is Julie Balmelli-Powe. I see her, not as much as I used to, but I used to always see her at the Boy Scout events because I think her sons are like Eagle Scouts, and she's really very involved in that whole part of the community and volunteering, and she's running for the Chehalis School Board. So let's listen to Julie. Let's listen to her vision and what she wants to do and help the Chehalis School District.
First, I'd like to thank you for giving me this opportunity to get my message out to your listeners. This is truly a blessing since my information didn't make it into the voter's guide. Who is Julie Balmelli-Powe? I was born and raised right here in the beautiful Chehalis Valley. I'm a third-generation farmer, an office manager, a devoted wife, and the proud mother of three amazing young adults. I am a plain-spoken, independent-thinking Christian constitutionalist. I graduated with honors from WF West, go Bearcats, earned my Associate of Science degree from Centralia College, go Trailblazers, and my Bachelor of Science from WSU. Go Cougs. I have served on several local county and state boards and have worked with several local, state, and federal agencies. I have spent the last 30 plus years working with youth as a coach, classroom volunteer, and a leader in the scouting BSA program. And the one thing I have witnessed was the more a parent is involved with their child, the better the child's success. The other thing I have witnessed through the years is how the system is slowly but steadily trying to remove the parents from the educational process, which in my opinion is one of the several factors that has led to decline in the proficiency in the core subjects. This is why I decided to run, to fight for parents, to be their voice on the Chehalis School Board.
If you're elected as a member of the Chehalis School Board, what is the top issue you'd like to address?
What is my top issue? I have several, but I'd say my number one issue is accountability to parents. I'm a firm believer that a school board member, or any elected official really, is elected by the people to represent the people. That is the core principle of our great republic, of the people, by the people, for the people. I am also a strong proponent of the Parents' Bill of Rights Act. And what is it that parents want? They want their kids to be taught the core subjects without all the propaganda. They want curriculum that prepares their child to be successful and productive citizens. They want decisions about their child's physical, mental, and reproductive health to be made by them, the parents. They want their kids to be safe and secure while they are in school. And mostly, they want transparency so they can verify exactly what they are getting.
School curriculum and its transparency has been an issue for some parents in the Chehalis School District. What would you do to help provide greater information to parents about what children are learning?
I'm all about transparency. I believe that parents and taxpayers should have access to everything. I think that all curriculum, textbooks, and titles to every book in the school library should be posted on the school website. And as far as books in the library, there shouldn't be any books whose pictures or texts are not age appropriate as not to harm a child's innocence. Movies and video games are rated. Books shouldn't be any different. I also believe parents should be allowed to sit in on their child's class occasionally, if they want to, without an appointment, so they can witness an actual lesson in what their children are being taught. As a parent myself, I stand with the parents and guardians of the students in the Chehalis School District. We have great schools and awesome teachers, and if we add more transparency and greater parental involvement, they can be exceptional.
All right, so that was Julie Balmelli-Powe. She's running for Chehalis School Board. So up next, and I didn't set this order because they're all kind of a little bit, they're not like back to back for the folks who are running in the same races, but next is going to be Kelly Smith Johnson. She's currently the mayor of Centralia, but mayors in Centralia are weak mayor. It's a weak mayor system. So no more power than other council members. So she's running for city council and in the city of Centralia, and she's running for re-election to the city council, which then the city council gets to appoint a person, because you're going to hear later on a candidate for Tenino mayor, which that's a stronger mayor system. So Linda, who you'll hear from after this, she's running for actual mayor of Tenino. So a little bit of a difference. It's kind of a different setup between Tenino and Centralia. But you're going to hear from Kelly and her vision for Centralia, maybe what she's done, what she's proud of, what she wants to do in the future to improve our community. So up next, we got Kelly Smith Johnston.
Hi, my name is Kelly Smith Johnston. I am running for re-election to Centralia City Council Position 2. I have lived in Centralia for 20 years. My dad served in the United States Air Force, so my family traveled a lot when I was young. But somehow we've all ended up living in Centralia together. I've raised two daughters as a single parent for the last 14 years. My youngest graduated from Centralia High School last year, and both are now in college. I also work full-time. I own a consulting practice, so I understand what it's like to run a small business. I am focused on addressing our current challenges, top of which are crime and housing. I'm also focused on building a vision for the future. As Centralia grows, we need to make sure we have a positive, vibrant vision we're working towards while we address our immediate needs. This vision includes neighborhood hubs and an interconnected trail system throughout Centralia. I hope to earn your vote this year.
Homelessness has become more visible throughout the city of Centralia. Over the past 4 years, as a city council member, what actions have you taken to address the homelessness crisis, and do you believe they've been effective?
Housing has been my top issue in my first term. I initiated the Lewis County Housing Summit and started the Housing Committee in Centralia. This issue has exploded in the last 4 years. The Boise decision, the COVID situation, and the opioid crisis have all contributed to it. Housing is a large topic in general, but to address homelessness specifically, we have created a temporary night-by-night shelter and are building a permanent one away from the downtown area. We've reviewed all the contracts at the county level and advocated that they be rewritten with clearer measures for accountability. We've made field trips to other places to see what they do and bring best practices here. We've passed ordinances addressing camping and RVs. We've closed Blakeslee Junction, and we've encouraged the development of all types of housing, including transitional, PSH, and low-income. Are these actions working? They're starting to. We're seeing improvements, but we're not there yet. It's going to take some time, and it's going to take some actions outside of your local government to fix it. All of these things are going to create change. We're working on it.
Crime is on the rise throughout Washington State, including the city of Centralia. Over the past 4 years as a city council member, what actions have you taken to address crime and safety, and do you believe they've been effective?
Crime is the number one concern I've heard about in the last 12 months. The people who live here, work here, and play here are concerned about the local crime. Fortunately, I can report that we have done a lot of things to work on this. We've added the flock safety camera system. We've just recently purchased a mobile camera that you'll see in Washington Park and other places. We've passed some ordinances, and we have worked to equip our local law enforcement professionals to do the job they're hired to do. We're tracking the trail for overdoses and who provides it, and we are getting arrests. We're solving many stolen car cases through flock safety, and we're finding ways to work with the non-pursuit laws and still address organized retail theft. And I'm proud to report that our crime statistics are down this year compared to last year. All of these things are working. And in addition to responding to the current situation, we need to think upstream. We've got to ensure our kids are getting a great start. I've supported the school levy, the United Learning Center. We need to create jobs and possibility and hope. All of these things will contribute to a flourishing Centralia.
All right, so we're back on Let's Talk About on AM 1470 KELA. And if you're just tuning in, you're tuning in a little late, but we still have four more candidates to hear from. We already heard from Dianne Dorey running for Port Commissioner in Centralia, Julie Balmelli-Powe running for Chehalis School Board, and Kelly Smith Johnston, the current mayor, who's running for city council again to get reelected and then maybe reappointed by that council for mayor. And so we listened to, you know, a little bit about, you know, the issues going on in our community, their solutions, what they've done, what they want to do. And I think it's important. And we've got a number of candidates coming up from Tenino Mayor, Centralia School Board, Rochester School Board, and we have another Port Commissioner in Centralia to hear from. So stay tuned. We're going to go to our sponsors for a short break. You're listening to AM 1470 KELA.
It's your local real estate professional, Heather Stewart with Blade Realty. With the changing real estate market, you may be thinking of sitting on the sidelines this quarter, but it's really a super time to stay in the game with buyer competition slowing and more inventory on the market. Now more than ever, you'll need that trusted resource with a proven reputation and track record to help you win in real estate. I'd love to be on your team. For stellar service in your real estate ventures, find me, Heather Stewart Realtor, on Facebook or at heatherstewartrealtor.com.
Since 1979, Goble Septic has been serving Southwest Washington with excellence for their customers and employees. If you want a career with a family-owned business, Goble Septic wants you. Goble is looking to fill CDL and non-CDL driver positions. Tired of working swing shifts and evenings? Want to be paid top dollar? Apply with Goble. Get full training, 100% paid medical, dental, and vision for employees, and more. Apply now at GobleSeptic.com. That's G-O-E-B-E-L, Septic.com. An equal opportunity employer.
Hi, this is Bob Holland. If you are seeking a no-cost direction on your shopping needs for medical insurance, whether family, senior, or group employer coverage, stop by our office at 612 West Main in Centralia across from KFC, or just give us a call at 360-736-7000. 360-736-4740. That's Bob Holland Insurance, 360-736-4740. That's 736-4740. Thank you.
Hey, this is John from Hub City Supply. We're excited to announce that we've been working closely with the PUD for the Energy Efficiency Rebate Program and the Low Income Grant Program. Call us today for a free estimate and a measurement for windows to help you create an energy efficient home, or visit us online at hubcitysupply.net. Let the window experts at Hub City Supply get you one step closer to living comfortably while saving you money. Hub City Supply, making your home look great from every angle.
Okay, and now back to business.
Listen on the air and online.
K-E-L-A. Let's talk about it.
All right, welcome back to Let's Talk About It on AM 1470 KELA. I'm your host today for our annual candidate interviews and questions, a little Q&A. A statement and then a few questions about, you know, more generalized, and they try to make them consistent. So if you're the incumbent and you're the challenger, you get a very common, similar question. So nobody thinks we're tipping the scale and putting our finger on it. Up next, Linda is running for mayor of Tenino to replace Wayne Fournier, who was running for a county commissioner in Thurston County. I think the last time I saw her, we were doing a ribbon cutting at a playground in Tenino. She's very active in the Tenino community. She's a current city council member already. And as I said, when Kelly Smith Johnson was talking, unlike Centralia with a weak mayor system, Tenino has a strong mayor type system where they run independently of the council as a mayor. So interesting to hear from Linda and hear what her vision is for Tenino, because Tenino's pretty active community. And so, and again, this is a situation where Wayne's moving to run for the county commission. So let's hear from Linda.
Hi, I'm Linda Gotovac, and I believe that I'm the best person to carry on with the great things that have been happening in Tenino in the last decade. I have been a part of that progress for 6 years. Also, I have extensive experience with the state legislature, having worked for them in different capacities for 43 years. I have several contacts, including Representative Peter Abbarno. Representative Abbarno has supported Tenino in the legislature because he sees the potential in our small city to do great things.
If you're elected mayor of Tenino, what is the top issue you'd like to address?
Better parking in the downtown area to attract more small business to Tenino. Also, continue the work in our beautiful park and recreation area. I would like to apply for grants, both state and federal, to help with our energy costs in the city. This would include helping low-income families. I will also be applying for grants and funding to continue the work on our roads.
If you're elected mayor, what will be your strategy for balancing economic growth with small-town charm?
Okay, first of all, Tenino does not have the room or capacity to allow large corporate interests to settle here. That is why we need to do things to attract small, family-owned businesses to our area. One of the things that I would do is provide more parking by making some of the streets head-in parking. Also, I would apply for grants to fix all the sidewalks.
All right, that was Linda Gotovac, who name-dropped a little bit, but I have worked with her from the state legislative standpoint on a lot of different things, from infrastructure to the parks when she was on city council. Now she's running for mayor, and to be honest, I mean, she's done a very good job, and it's always a pleasure working with her, so I don't mind her doing a little name-drop there. But up next, Mandi McDougall. Mandi is the incumbent on the Centralia School Board. She's a photographer. You've probably seen her place downtown in Centralia, and I just saw her this week at the Centralia Chehalis Middle School game, where she is supporting her son in the team. You'll hear from her, and later this year, we're going to hear from her a little bit about the Lighted Tractor Parade, which she's involved in. But for now, let's hear from her about what she's done on the Centralia School Board, and what her plans are for the future.
Good morning. My name is Mandi McDougall, and I'm running for Centralia School District Director Position 4. Some things you should know about me. I'm a Centralia High School graduate from the class of 2002. I've been married to my husband, Christopher, for 16 years, and we are proud parents of two children, ages 9 and 13, who are fourth-generation Centralia Tigers. Professionally, I've owned and operated a photography business in downtown Centralia for the last 14 years. Over the last decade, I've been lucky to serve our community in many ways. I was the coordinator of Centralia MOPS, I was a founding member, and I'm currently the president of the nonprofit Kidding Around, and I am the event coordinator for both the Lighted Tractor Parade and the Summerfest Parade in Centralia, and have been honored to serve on the Centralia School Board for the past 4 years.
If you're reelected as a member of the Centralia School Board, what is the top issue you'd like to address in your term?
I believe the top issue facing our district today, and the one at the top of my list to tackle over the next 4 years, is student achievement and test scores. I wish there was a simple answer to get all of our students back on track. I believe the solution instead is multi-layered. We have to address behavior challenges so that we have more time to focus on learning in our classrooms. We must continue to hold all of our staff to a high level of expectation, and we must support them through effective professional development and training. We also need our community and parents to be actively engaged in the critical work we are undertaking as a district.
With school districts finding it difficult to pass levies and bonds, how do you address the need for school and student funding in Centralia?
Something at the forefront of every school board director's mind is the work of passing school bonds and levies. I think we all wish school funding was less complicated than it is. Our job as elected school board directors is to represent all of the community that has elected us. And that is a tough job to do in this aspect when our community is clearly so split on the issue. I hear just as often from people who want us to ask for less as I do from people who want us to continue to ask for $1.50 or more. My hope as we move forward in our discussion about another levy vote is that we look at options at and under $1.50 with a specific outline of what each dollar amount will fund, and that we will stay committed to our current goals of raising test scores, addressing student safety and behavior, and overall being responsive to our community's feedback so that saying yes to levy funding is an easier decision. I am proud to be from Centralia. We have bright, courageous students, kind-hearted and hardworking staff, a respectful and dedicated school board, and the most amazing superintendent who goes above and beyond every single day to serve our community. It has been a challenge, an incredible learning opportunity, and a joy to serve on the Centralia School Board for the last 4 years, and I hope I will have your vote to work hard for the next four.
All right, that was Mandy McDougall running for re-election to the Centralia School Board. And then up next, we have Michael Morrow. Mike Morrow is running for Rochester School Board, and like you heard earlier, a very important position. All the school board members are talking about scores, learning loss, parental involvement, and let's hear what his plan is for the Rochester School Board.
My name is Mike Morrow. I'm a father, manager, and a small business, and have been a member of the Rochester community for a little over 9 years now. My daughter was an A student and had a passion for learning. As Rochester's priorities in education shifted, we watched dollars move away from academics, science, arts, and sports. So my daughter's passion for learning suffered, and as a result, her grades dropped. My son, he's lost all passion for school altogether. And this is why I am running for school board. I think it's time to turn this ship around and start addressing priorities to assure every student in Rochester School District graduates with the academics, critical thinking skills, and that they are prepared for lifelong learning to be competitive in the workplace and to become productive members in our community.
If you're elected as a member of the Rochester School Board, what is the top issue you'd like to address?
Well, there's several that we could address, but I'm going to stick with primarily recognizing the parents as primary stakeholders and me being the voice for all the constituents. Because in our school district, we have seen top-down decision-making versus stakeholders' input from our community. And as being a primary stakeholder, this seems to have been lost in our community. By doing this, we will need to review and weigh all policies that aren't in line with academics. I would like to reestablish academics as a priority, such as science, technology, English, arts, and math. We will need to look at the budget and look at if there are cuts to be made to become fiscally responsible with the tax dollars we get. Lastly, transparency in curriculum. I've had a few emails in regards to this, and parents want to know what their kids are learning in school.
With some school districts having a difficult time passing levies and bonds, how do you address the need for school and student funding?
First off, educating the public. You can look at it, levies are for learning, bonds are for buildings. I believe as a school district, if we're going to ask for money, that we should be able to show the public that we handle our funds responsibly.
All right, that was Mike Morrow, who is running for the Rochester School Board. And so up next, we have Peter Lahmann. So Peter's running for re-election to the Port Commission in Centralia. His opponent, you heard from earlier, Dianne Dorey. Again, another, a very important position. If you look at, historical trends, only about 40% of Washington voters turn out to vote. And these local races are really essential. Ports are taxing districts. They build infrastructure, create jobs, attract businesses, and also provide a tax base. They provide employees who pay taxes into the system. So really important from school board to port that we turn out to vote, because ballots are getting mailed out today and tomorrow, and it's the start of the 18-day voting period through Election Day. We need to make sure that we turn out to vote, and Peter's going to tell you why you should vote for him.
Hey, my name is Peter Lahmann, and I'm running for Centralia Port Commissioner, District 3, and I'm a lifetime resident of Centralia. My wife and I own a home here. We own a small business and have since like 1990. I got on the Centralia Port in 2018. That was my first time to run, and I didn't want to be one of those people that sat back and complained and didn't do something. So I ran for the commission. I got into the position. I'm a Centralia High School grad, Centralia College grad. I'm the president of the Lewis County Historical Society. I represent Lewis County on the Pack Mountain Workforce Board, and I'm on several other committees and boards. So that's kind of my background. Thank you.
If you are reelected as a member of the Centralia Port, what is the top issue you'd like to address in your term?
I think the biggest issues that we have with the Port of Centralia are lack of communication and transparency. I hear from the constituents that they are looking, you know, they want to know what the port's doing. The port was originally set up to be an economic driver, which it is, to bring business, to bring jobs to the community, which they do. But people would like to know how they're doing it, when they're doing it, and why they're doing it. So transparency, openness, that's the main issues that we would like to address.
There's been a lot of internal turmoil surrounding the port in the news, such as conflicts of interest, interference with labor practices, and transparency concerns. How have you helped resolve issues within the port? And if reelected, how will you continue to do so?
Yeah, the resolving of issues, once again, I think it gets back to communication. Without sitting down and having good discussion between the commissioners, it's going to be very difficult to resolve those issues. I've heard it said, oh, I don't support WinCo, or I don't support this or that. I was in construction my whole life until I retired, and I've done numerous developments and housing developments and things like that. So I can't come in here and say that I'm against WinCo. I just want the people to know what's going on. And, you know, the local residents, the neighbors around the Centralia Station project, they all deserve to know what's going on.
All right. So there you go. You're listening to AM 1470. Let's talk about the candidate interview show. And I want to, this was day one, because day two, we have more candidates. I think we have six or seven more candidates for tomorrow as well. But we did hear from Dianne Dorey, Centralia Port Commission race. We heard from Julie Balmelli-Powe with the Chehalis School Board race. Kelly Smith Johnston for Centralia School, Centralia City Council, Linda Gotovac, Tenino Mayor, Mandi McDougall, Centralia School Board, Mike Morrow, Rochester School Board, and Peter Lahmann for Port. So you got a kind of a wide range. And as I said earlier, today and tomorrow really starts that 18-day voting period where ballots are mailed out and you can start turning them in. You can go to sos.wa.gov. That's for the Secretary of State of Washington. So sos.wa.gov to look at the deadlines, make sure you're registered, check on your ballot that it got in and it was accepted. October 30th, the online and mail registrations must be received 8 days before Election Day. November 7th, obviously, is the deadline for Washington State voter registrations or updates. And that's the same day as ballots are due. They need to be postmarked or returned by November 7th or on November 7th. So 40%, that means 4 out of 10 people. That means 6 out of 10 people. If you're in a room right now of 10 people, only about 4 of you are going to vote. 4 of you are going to determine your local policies, local values for the other 6. And that's why local races are so important. I know myself, being a state representative, I mean, I work really closely with our local elected officials on trying to build policy and try not to pass policy that doesn't recognize or doesn't appreciate what those local values are or what the local elected officials want to do. So it's so important for people to turn out and make sure they vote. So I thank you for tuning in for the annual, because it's annual, we do it every year that there's an election, the annual candidate interviews and Q&A here on KELA. And I want to thank KELA for letting us do this. After today and tomorrow's interviews, we're going to run these on Sunday's Let's Talk About It. So this Sunday and next Sunday, we're going to rerun these interviews so that you, if you missed it or you want to share it or you want to let people know, here's what you need to know about these candidates. These candidates are going to be on the radio today, tomorrow, and then again, these successive Sundays on Let's Talk About It Sunday that I host as well. Thank you for tuning in, and be sure to tune in tomorrow at 8:30 right here on AM 1470 KELA, or you can stream the show at KELAAM.com. Have a great Thursday. Thanks, everyone.